That's Ivy Vulcan and Andy
Vulcan. Moving on to that awesome Ring Bearers group. Sawyer Vulcan.
So let's just bow our head in a word of prayer. Dear Lord, we gather in this place in the spirit of celebration and gratitude. Thank you for blessing and bringing the marriage today of Tim and Abby. We ask that you bless this food that we are about to eat, their marriage, their family, and all of their relationships. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right, have a big round of applause for the best man. He's got a lot of responsibilities. All right, here you go.
Thank you. Welcome, everybody. Thanks for coming tonight. Obviously, amazing crowd and some wonderful people here tonight. First and foremost, Abby, you look fantastic tonight. Let's get a round of applause for her. My name is Mike Fitzner, and if you're thinking, yes, I am the much better looking and smarter older brother of this guy standing behind me right here. Thanks to the Vulcan family for, you know, all the work, hospitality, effort that's gone into this beautiful day. Abby, it's absolutely perfect. I know you put a lot of effort and attention into it, and it turned out to be a great night. So thanks for all that. I've known this guy here for about 46 years and seen and experienced many of life's ups and downs, like we all have. You know, similar to the Vulcan family, we grew up in a family very involved in athletics, and that was a big part of what we did. You know, talking with Casey and Barry and their upbringing, you know, our families were very similar, and our experiences and memories through athletics have provided us a lot of things. Tim and I would also battle a lot in the backyard when I was beating him in wiffle ball and football and basketball and basically everything that's available out there. He might say something different. Tim has a lot of wonderful qualities. He's definitely has a tough guy bravado, but he has a big heart at the end of the day. He's funny, he's giving. I can't read what you wrote here. What are the other great qualities you have? Yeah. I do know that Tim was fortunate enough to bump into a wonderful woman a few years ago. I would agree that with Abby's comments about opposites attracting, I think Tim and Abby are a great complement to each other. You know, Abby, outgoing and on the go. Tim, laid back, wants to relax at home. Abby, very mainstream. Tim, certainly very opinionated. Abby is an organizer and a planner. Tim kind of flies by the seat of his pants. Abby's a beautiful woman. Tim is kind of the opposite. All in love, of course. Just a couple quick thank yous. I just wanted to thank my parents, Rick and Joe. For all they've done for me and my siblings over the years, I just can't thank them enough. I wanted to give a quick shout out to our Uncle Arjun as well, who's here tonight. He would travel around the Midwest with us as well, watching a lot of athletic events and doing all that. I also want to thank my better half, Mandy, who came with me from the Upper Peninsula tonight. Her daughter Paige and her son Jack, and just want to thank them for making the trip out and being a part of the night as well. Lastly, Dell, Pam, Casey, Tana, Barry, Kelly, kids. It's been a pleasure to meet all you guys, get to know you guys. Couldn't be happier that Tim is joining such a wonderful family and just great people across the board. And I know there's a lot of Vulcans here tonight. Abby, I know you found a man who completely adores you. We'll always take care of you. I also know you're the best thing that could have happened to him. And he... I know you'll love him deeply, and you'll definitely keep him in mind. In line, excuse me. And in mind, yes. Just a shot in the dark, but I'm guessing there might be some more Fitzner kids arriving in the not-too-distant future. So just throwing that out there. As many of you know, becoming a parent changes your life instantly. And I know when the time comes, these two will be amazing parents. Abby, part of the reason I know this is because of your experience with Tim. Similar to infants and small children's, he should not be left alone or unsupervised for long periods of time. So definitely keep that in mind when you're talking about him. All kidding aside, I love my brother deeply, and I want nothing but the best for these two. And you guys are a perfect match for one another. Let's raise our glasses. Let's toast to the happy couple, family, friends, and forever after.
Yeah, hear, hear.
Having an amazing day today, celebrating the bride and groom. So I've been taking some notes for a while on what I would say at Abby's wedding. So here it goes. Oh,
here it comes.
Hold 1 second. He's safe. Cool. The notes. Thank you, buddy. Thank you very much. It's a little tattered. It's, you know, there's a lot of notes. Okay. Chapter 1. I'm just kidding. I did have to write this down, though, so I could go through this with minimal tears. As you can see, a lot of hormones going on right now. And 2, so I don't ramble, because there's a lot of memories that have happened between Abby and I. So I'm going to try and keep this short and sweet and get this party started in true Abby fashion. All right. Most of you know me. But for those of you that don't, I'm Allie, and I was Abby's first partner. I'm not just her maid of honor, and no, she is not the father of this baby. So Abby and I go way back. We met in 7th grade when I transferred over to Nicollet. I was about a week, I was there about a week, and invited her to my birthday party sleepover, and we've been friends ever since. When we both moved back to Minnesota after college, we decided to live together for a short 13 years. I know what you're all thinking, why such a short amount of time? Well, we were in our mid-30s, inching to late 30s, and thought, hey, we should probably start adulting on our own. So being we were both there, we decided to split. We went through so much together, highs, lows, and everything in between. We became co-workers, gathering around our water cooler, better known as our kitchen sink, during the pandemic, and our friendship survived. I'd say we're going pretty strong. It's hard to describe what Abby and I are to each other. When people ask, I really have to think about all the things she is to me. I think she would agree that we both probably wear many titles. Childhood friend, roommate, moviegoer, travel buddy, teammate, concert goer, all things music lover, faith friends, honorary Vulcan, best friend, sister from another mister, and my favorite, family by choice. Okay, here the hormones come. I think everyone here would agree that there isn't anyone who deserves this happiness more than Abby. The many conversations we have had over the years, patiently praying and waiting for it to be your turn, has finally came. God knew you needed someone that matched and could support your awesomeness, so it couldn't just be anyone. He carefully was crafting a person that knew your love for independence, hiking, camping, all things outdoors, cooking, cricketing, not the sport, crafting cricketing, music, festivals, sports, and traveling. From the day you met Tim and texted me, I could tell you felt this was different. You told me you had felt more yourself than you ever have with someone. I remember you telling me that when Tim told you he loved you, there were three reasons why he fell in love with you. You love him as he is and aren't trying to change him, your independence, and your big heart, which everyone would agree here, Abby is so easy to love. I'm so excited to see where your journey takes you as a married couple, and I can't wait for all the memories yet to come. You've been there for me through all the things, and I feel so blessed that I can do the same for you. When I first met Tim, it was at a Vikings game. Yes, a Vikings game. Right there should tell you that I was excited to meet this guy that Abby was gushing over, being a very loyal and dedicated Packer fan. But I put that aside to spend some dedicated time to get to know this guy that was going to be caring for one of the most important people in my life. Tim, right away, I felt like it was easy with you. You fit in so well with the Vulcans, and seeing how you are with the kids, I know means not only so much to Abby, but also to their family. You instantly felt like a brother to me with the quick banter back and forth that we have, and that really sold it for me. Whenever I went to Abby with hard moments, you were right there offering your support, and you may not have known it, but that did mean the world to me. Tim, take care of our girl. She's the best. Okay, I'm done. Okay, if everyone could raise their glass, please. Abby and Tim, as you start this life together, remember to always look out for each other, care deeply, love hard, and don't sweat the small stuff. You have an amazing life ahead of you, and I'm so pumped to be cheering you on from the front row. I love you guys. Cheers.
Cheers.
Hello, I am Katie, the other maid of honor. Yes, there is two of us. It was not a competition, let's just say that. She just couldn't decide between the two of us. Last night, Allie was going through her speech with me, and I thought I had some things I just needed to clarify for everybody here, so we were all sort of on the same page. As Allie mentioned, she has known Abby since seventh grade. I have known Abby since birth. Since the hospital, I have known Abby. Yes, Allie is expecting in August, but I have already gave birth to three kids, and I have twins that are born on Abby's birthday. Same day. Same day. Ask Allie also mentions that they have lived together for 13 years, and my birthday is December 13th, so that's a tie. Tim, you may be asking yourself, is this little competition between Abby and Allie, or Abby, oh no, Allie and myself, I'm Katie.
I'm used to it, we're used to it. She's Abby, I'm Allie.
Whoever. Abby, if this little competition is going to continue between myself and Allie once you're married. But no, it is not. You just get to be a part of it now. Abby, you are my best friend, my BFF, my ride or die, and my sister, my fourth sister that I never had. All joking aside, you're an amazing friend, sister, daughter, and now wife. Let's raise our glasses. Mine is liquor and hers is water or nothing. So whoever wants to hang out with me later, cheers to the great couple. I love you guys.
All right, we got Del coming up now. Let's hear for Del.
Well, believe me, I'm not going to go on as long as those two girls did, okay? Tim and Abby. I've said this to other couples as they got married, and I think it's really good advice. You have a choice. You can look for the good, or you can look for the bad in the other person. And if you choose to look for the good, life will be good to you, okay?
Good one.
I want to welcome everyone here. We look forward to getting to know Rick and Joe and the Pfister family much more in the future. We thank everyone for coming to this wedding tonight. It's a pleasure just to know and see everyone. I got a few stories, just a couple. Very, very less on Tim, but I knew Tim was going to be a keeper the first time we met him because he knew how to play pinochle. Now, Tim's version of pinochle is by the book, and Dell's version of pinochle is the Balkan family Nicklet rules. So we've kind of worked things out now, and we do play pinochle with a combination of the rules. Abby was such a good daughter growing up. I have very little to say, because you always want to talk about things to your daughter. But when we lived in Germany, everybody would come up and say, "Oh, you're Abby's dad," because she was a social butterfly. One time Abby threw a party, and we weren't there. How I know she had a party was, we had a nice picnic card table from my aunt and uncle with 3/4-inch board on it, was broken half. Now, Abby didn't say who it was, but she did rebuild it. We'd still have that card table today. So, not to be beat by the other two that were up here, or three really, I'm going to just say thank you, have fun, drive safe when you go home, and let's party.
Let's get another round of applause for this awesome couple.
All right, we're going to keep this short and sweet because I know we're already cutting into the dance time, but I just want to give a huge thank you to everybody for coming here today. I know some are near, some are far, and from the bottom of our heart, we really appreciate you making the time to come out here. Also, a big thank you to our families. I know my parents, Del and Pam, Tim's parents, Rick and Joe, and all of everybody that helped make this possible. I can't even say names because there were so many people that stepped in to help and make this wedding what it is and make it the best day. So honestly, thank you everybody for coming. Thank you for everybody that's been helping, and just can't wait to dance the night away.
I'm going to keep this short and sweet so I don't get emotional. Everyone that's here, thank you for coming. We're overjoyed to have you here. I want a reminder to tell you to tip the bartenders. The alcohol is free. A couple bucks wouldn't hurt them. And yeah, let's just have a good time the rest of the night. And thanks again to everyone for coming.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is what we've all been waiting for. The bride and groom's first dance.
Take my hand, let me make you mine. I'm through waiting, taking my time. Never felt like this before. Take my name and make it yours. I hope you don't think it's a little bit crazy saying this all so soon. But baby, it's the right time. Knew it from the first time that I laid eyes on you. It's okay, let them say what they want. They might think I should wait, but I don't. No, I don't wanna waste a minute. Girl, I want you in every single part of my world. So take my hand, let me make you mine. I'm through waiting, taking my time. Never felt like this before. Take my name and make it yours. I know I'm the last guy.
Floor. Who wants the polka? Come on, I see some polka people out there. Let's come up to the dance floor and join them.